You can't spend much time in Texas City with all the big ships that come and go, the oil and chemical refineries, the pipelines and storage tanks brimming with flammable products. You can't spend much time here without thinking the unthinkable. Could it happen again? Could Texas City be another boom town in the worst possible way? Fifty years ago, Texas City burned its way into the nation's conscience. The worst industrial accident in American history made Texas City synonymous with disaster. The day it happened, Will Lane was very near the epicenter.
It was real strange. I'm real glad to be alive.
Lane was a young chemist at the Monsanto chemical plant. He remembers seeing the bright orange smoke from a burning ship. Firefighters were busy pouring water on the French freighter Grand Camp at the city docks across from the Monsanto plant.
You could look at it, and it was real pretty to watch. And there were townspeople by the hundreds that lined the part of our parking lot that was nearest to the ship. They came down to watch a fire.
Texas City had a new fire truck, and this was its first day out. 27 firemen were on the docks trying to put out the fire. The burning ship was so hot, the water around it was boiling. But as a chemist, there was something about that orange-colored smoke that worried Will Lane.
We could see bits and pieces of paper bagging going up into the air and away. And my boss thought, and I thought too, that we were witnessing a nitrate fire. But someone had said, it's a grain ship. The grain is on fire.
So believing it was only a matter of time before the fire was out, Will Lane went back to work at the Monsanto lab. But the fire was growing hotter, and the orange smoke was attracting an even larger crowd along the docks.
It was a very, very strong sulfur in the air, sulfur fumes.
Herb Metzger watched the fire while talking to a group of high school kids.
This smoke was just a beautiful orange.
Mary Hunter, a Monsanto secretary, was watching from her office window. And across town, Mrs. Knappenberger, a housewife with a home camera, came here to the Texas City dike to get a closer look at the burning ship. She didn't know it then, but she was about to record America's greatest man-made disaster. The ship had been loaded not with grain, but with ammonium nitrate fertilizer, the same ingredient that would be used years later in the Oklahoma City bombing. The Texas City blast was so strong, it registered as an earthquake in Denver, 900 miles away. It created a tidal wave that washed a barge into a parking lot. Two airplanes circling the ship were blasted from the sky. Flying debris punctured chemical storage tanks, creating an even larger inferno.
We have another truck up here off of the road. It had about 10 or 15 men, and they were all crushed.
The explosion killed at least 581 people, including school children who had come to watch the fire. But the danger was far from over. Tomorrow, we'll hear the stories of survival and courage from the people who were there 50 years ago. Charles Hadlock, 11 News, Texas City.